But let's kick off with our first opening lick, which is based around the B minor pentatonic. To kick things off, I came out of our climbing little chord part there from the AE power chord, and I did a kind of signature Gary Moore fast trill there between 7 and 9 on the D. For all of this sort of front end, you should be visualizing the B minor pentatonic predominantly that scale, although every so often we add that C sharp note in. This first lick, I've borrowed it from Walking By Myself, okay? So it sounds something like this. Okay, we start off by bending 9 up a whole tone on the G, and then 7 to 9 on the G, and then 9 on the D, and then 7 on the G to 9 on the D, and then bending 9 up a whole tone, twice on the G at the 9th fret, and then we play 7 on the G and 9 on the D. Then we have this little lick, this little repetition. That is basically 7 on the G to 9 and 7 on the D, and then 9 on the A. And then we go up again. So that's 7 and 9 on the D. So. And then we have 7 on the G to 9 on the D twice. And then we bend 9 up a whole tone. Release, pull off to 7. And then play 9 on the D. And then we hammer on from 7 to 9 on the G string. Okay, for the next lick, I borrowed this lick from Still Got the Blues, or something similar to Still Got the Blues. And we're sort of switching pentatonics here. You could look at this as being a mixture of the F sharp minor pentatonic and also the E minor pentatonic, because we target that G note. Basically, it's something for you to sort of remember is that when you're playing a blues, all of these pentatonics will work over each other. I really like the sound if I'm playing a B minor pentatonic or a B minor chord to play an F sharp minor pentatonic over it. And that's something that you'll hear in Gary Moore's playing quite a lot. Or he'll simply just be playing a B minor pentatonic with that added C sharp on the top. Anyway, the lick sounds like this. So it's got quite a sort of stuttery sort of feel. So what you're doing is you're hammering on 7 up to 10, and then on the B string, and then 7 and 8 on the top E. And you pull off to 7 on the E, and then play 10 on the B. Okay, and then we play 7 on the top E again. Pull off 10 to 7 on the B. And then play 9 on the G. And then 7, 10 on the B. And 7 on the top E. Bend 10 up a whole tone on the B. And then finish off by targeting that 8th fret on the B string. So you get this. Okay, and actually we to finish off, there's a little kind of subtle hammer on between 8 and 10 on the B string. Then we have this little rundown, which is again, this is sort of a Thin Lizzy-esque sort of lick. If you listen to Waiting for an Alibi, you'll hear little pentatonic flurries like this quite a lot. So we're going 10 on the top E, and then 7, 10, 7, and then play 10 on the beat. And then that's 7, 10, 7 on the B, and 9 on the G. And then we've got 7, 9, 7, and slide down to 6. And then we've got this sliding into 9 on the D string, and then hammering 7 to 9 on the D, and then slide down to 7 on the A, 5 on the A, and 7 on the bottom E. So
we all have some of our favorite songs we'd like to learn note for note. At licklibrary.com, you'll find hundreds of note-for-note lessons to great songs. As a member, you'll get unlimited access to all these lessons, plus much more. At licklibrary.com, the original online musicians community.